Call out your money.
Call out your money.
Wake up. Get up.
Things that the blind does not need a guide to decipher. They include the taste of saltless soup and the beauty of the 95th Annual National Conference of the Pharmaceutical Society of Nigeria, PSN, held in Jos. Tagged TIN CITY 2022, the conference with the theme Medicine Security in an Unstable Economy and the sub-theme Stemming the Misuse and Abuse of Essential Medicines in a Depressed Economy, saw bigwigs in the field of pharmacy of Nigerian descent from all parts of the world, deliberating the way out of Nigeria's health woes. The conference saw the training of pharmacists on vaccination and life supports emergency through the combined efforts of the National Association of Pharmacists and Pharmaceutical Scientists in the Americas, NAPSA, led by Dr. Teresa Isiche Pounds, and the Director of Transgenerational Foundation, Dr. Samuel Adekola, as part of the preliminary events. Pharmacists were engaged in sporting events and exercises prior to the opening ceremony, including golf championship, football match, and fitness walk. Led by the president of the society and his wife, pharmacist Professor Cyril Odianose, and associate professor pharmacist Stella Usifo. The governor of Plateau State, Right Honorable Barrister Simon Baku Lalong, CON, and his wife, Mrs. Regina Lalong, were all out to welcome the men of honor as Professor Usifo set record in his first national conference as the PSN president. Though the conference started on October 31, the opening ceremony held the next day, November 1, with numerous dignitaries in attendance. The governor, represented by his deputy, Professor Sonny Gwanle Tioden, performed the opening ceremony.
In Mabudi, in Lantan South. We are currently supporting the Plateau State Public Health Emergency Operations Center in curbing emergency diseases like COVID-19, monkeypox, Lassa fever, cholera, and others, which indicate the proactiveness of our administration towards emergency situations. In line with the above, we are keying in to the National Emergency Medical Services and Ambulance System of the federal government. Distinguished personalities and resource persons, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank you and appreciate you all for not only coming, but attending this opening remark session and listening attentively. I have attended many conferences here, but to be honest, I have never seen this place this full. For those coming into the state for the first time, enjoy your stay and the serene environment and weather of Jos. On this note, I hereby declare the conference open for the benefit of humanity and the grace of God. Thank you.
In his keynote address, the Director General and Chief Executive Officer, National Institute for Pharmaceutical Research and Development, NIPRD, pharmacist Dr. Obi Peter Adigwe, urged the government to invest in local manufacture of drugs, as that is Nigeria's area of comparative advantage.
Political will. Say anything you like about this administration. This administration has focused on enabling us to develop our own capacity by ourselves. Sometimes it has not been done very correctly. I'm a scientist and I will tell you the truth. Sometimes it hasn't been done correctly by the political stakeholders. But the gap is in their advisors, not in the political way. If you tell Buhari now that banning importation of medicines is what will make local manufacturers grow, he will do that. And there is demonstrable evidence, like I said, in the 2016 fiscal policy, this government ring-fenced four categories: antibiotics, antimalarials, alkaloids, and hematinics for local manufacture. And that led to a corresponding double-digit growth in factories within Nigeria. Similarly, Executive Order No. 4F that was done by Professor Yemi Osinbajo when he was acting president singled out pharmaceuticals in Section 4F, saying that government establishments must procure made in Nigeria medicines for use in their facilities. Is there an executive order? And then the minister mentioned biovaccines. How many governments across the world will put forward 3 billion naira of its own money to partner with a local manufacturer in order to produce vaccines locally?
PSN President thanked the federal government and President Muhammadu Buhari for the enactment of the Pharmacy Council Act 2022, signed on August 16, while calling on the government to do all it can to stem the tide of brain drain hitting the country.
Pay our gratitude to the federal government and most especially President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, for this landmark ascent to the Pharmacy Bill. I find it imperative to call on the presidency and other arms of government that the Pharmacy Bill has the propensity to restore normalcy to our indecorous drug distribution channel, which have made Nigeria famous for the fake drug syndrome. Again, we encourage the federal government to stimulate functional petrochemical industries that guarantees an industrial revolution beyond pharma industry. We must become primary producers of active pharmaceutical ingredients, API, excipients, equivalents, packaging materials, and other finished products in a determined bid to attain medicine sufficiency and security. President Buhari can consolidate the gains of the Act, Pharmacy Act 2022, as he critically evaluates our proposals in this regard.
In his remarks and response, the Minister of Health, Professor Ehanire Osage, who spoke through Professor Pokop Bopwatda, the Chief Medical Director, Jos University Teaching Hospital, assured pharmacists that the government will do all it can to ensure that the country's pharma sector remains competitive in Africa and the world.
APIs, you have a responsibility to transform this country from a vaccine consumer nation into a vaccine manufacturing nation for local use and for export purposes. We must leverage on the African continent free trade zone as a new frontier of international trade capability, capable of stabilizing our economy. The government will continue to create the environment that ensures that Nigerian pharma sector remains continentally competitive in the short term and later globally. We look forward to surpassing the pharma sector GDP contribution between 1.5 to 2.5 billion US dollars to at least 4 billion US dollars in the next decade. This means the country will partly rely on the achievements of medicines and vaccine security to stabilize the economy.
In her goodwill message, the Director General, National Agency for Food and Drug Administration and Control, NAFDAC, pharmacist Professor Mojisola Adeyeye, who spoke through the Director, Pharmacovigilance and Post-Marketing Surveillance of NAFDAC, stated that medicine security implies that people have access to quality drugs despite their socio-cultural bounds. She noted that the agency implements that to the letter.
One, distinguished pharmacist colleagues, to this opening ceremony, the 95th annual meeting of the Pharmaceutical Society of Nigeria, which is the first of the new presidents, and it's exciting to note that it is very well attended. Thank you, Plateau State, for the representation. The theme, medicine security in an unstable economy, is apt and timely in view of the current economic situation in the country, the skyrocketing prices of essential goods and commodities, and the unfavorable GDP coupled with the decline of the Naira. The international market forms a critical mass of the source of our drugs, and the subject of medicine security cannot be overemphasized, considering its critical importance in healthcare delivery and contributions to universal health coverage in Nigeria and across the globe. Medicine security implies that every health facility, healthcare professional, healthcare provider, and patient everywhere around the world has reliable, equitable access to medicine supplies that they need to achieve good health at all times.
The Director General, Nigerian Natural Medicine Development Agency, pharmacist Dr. Samuel Ogene Itatuvie, who was represented by his technical advisor on research, planning and innovation, pharmacist Daniel Sue, stressed that pharmacists need to come into the business of natural medicine as the agency has perfected the plans of working with pharmacists, adding that over 60% of the practitioners at present are not pharmacists.
To use in fighting medicine insecurity. Natural medicine is one of the platforms we can use as a silver bullet in fighting medicine insecurity. Therefore, I'm challenging the entire house today for pharmacists to come on board and join us in this fight. Nigerian Natural Medicine Development Agency has developed 14 products currently undergoing NAFTA listing processes, and we are open for business. We have a facility, four-story building facility, a new laboratory complex, which will soon be commissioned, and it has sufficient sophisticated equipment for analysis. We are open to university collaborations, research and other organizations to come on board to push this frontier forward. Permit me to mention this. As Natural Medicine Development Agency, we have paved way for pharmacists in such a way that the African Free Continental Trade Agreement Protocol is in favor of pharmacists. Please come on board so that you can take advantage of this platform.
The Vice President, International Pharmaceutical Federation, FIP, and President, African Pharmaceutical Forum, APF, Dr. Prosper Higg, while thanking Professor Usifo for inviting him to the conference.
As the five other conferences that I've already attended, but it was a special visit, special invitation for me, because I was elected Vice President of FIP in September in Seville, and I came here to thank Nigerian pharmacists to have supported me for the election. That is why I'm here mainly to say thank you to PSN President, thank you to Nigerian pharmacists.
Noted that the PSN is a pillar of support to the APF. The special guest of honor and chairman, National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, Brigadier General Bubar Marwa retired, who spoke through the secretary of the agency, Barrister Shadrack Usman Haruna, to mark the beginning of plenary, stressed that about 14 million Nigerians between the ages of 15 and 65 are reportedly involved in drug abuse, while highlighting how pharmacists could help to solve the problem.
Attention to our current drug situation. Aside from the agency's effort in drug supply production, which includes a successful clampdown on the cultivation, production, sale, importation, exportation, and interdiction of trafficking in narcotic and psychotropic substances, part of the efforts to prevent the use and misuse of essential medicine is in the development of the fourth edition of the National Drug Control Master Plan, 2021 to 2025. It's a strategic document to strengthen responses to drugs to contribute to enhanced health, security and well-being of Nigerians.
The President, West African Postgraduate College of Pharmacy, Professor Cecilia Igwilo, who spoke through the college's General Secretary, Professor Ibrahim Oreagba, enjoined pharmacists to embrace specialization as the era of general practice was long gone.
The key objectives of the college is to train and produce specialists. As we all know, we're in the era of specialization. I normally say something. If you focus on your focus, then you will become the focus. We have passed the level of being a general pharmacist or a general practice pharmacist. We want to recognize more and more people that are specializing in specialties in pharmacy. And I can assure you that is happening now. That is happening in most of our health institutions. And when we do this, we are impacting on the patient positively, and we're also impacting on our colleagues, from the medics to the nurses to everybody. When you specialize, you have an in-depth knowledge of that particular aspect of pharmacy, and people will recognize you for that.
The Conference Planning Committee Chairman, pharmacist Victor Adekoye, while thanking all for their participation in the conference, urged everyone to fully maximize all that had been made available, ranging from tourism, recreational, sports and cultural facilities.
Thank all members of the Conference Planning Committee for their time and effort during the planning that made this gathering a reality. Also, kudos to the local organizing committee team that helped on the ground activities. They ensured they work on the accommodation list. I say a heartfelt thank you to all sponsors, as well as all our special guests and speakers at the plenary sessions. And to all, I say stay warm and enjoy as the event unfolds here in the City of Jobs. Thank you very much.
The President, Nigerian Association of Pharmacists and Pharmaceutical Scientists in the Americas, NAPSA, Dr. Teresa Isiche Pounds, while noting that the organization is part and parcel of the PSN, added that it will continually support the healthcare service in Nigeria.
It's really a pleasure to be here today as a proud Nigerian to speak to this wonderful crowd. Please give yourself a warm hand. And I'm not just speaking for myself, I'm speaking for the members of NAPSA who are here with me today. We are based in the United States. I guess you're going to ask, why are we here? We are here because a lot of us are Nigerians. And we care about what's happening in Nigeria. And we want to make sure that you all know that we know and care about what's happening in our country. Now, I'm just going to pick one thing, one of the goals that we do. Now, our mission is to promote healthy living, disease prevention through effective pharmaceutical care and facilitation of efficient healthcare delivery system and strategies in America. I want you to realize the next one: Nigeria, Africa, and the rest of the world.
The Plateau State Branch Chairman of the PSN, pharmacist Kaneng Pam, expressed her profound gratitude to the governor who supported the hosting of the event under her administration.
It's infinite mercy for you to be here today. Today is indeed the day that our Lord has made, and under my leadership, we are highly delighted to host the annual national conference with the theme, Medicine Security in an Unstable Economy. Activities marking the successful commencement of this August occasion started on Saturday by the arousing reception accorded our dear President, Professor Cyril Osifo. While in Jos, the Plateau State Capital, I wish you all a memorable conference and permit me to, on behalf of the Plateau people, to say in Angas, we say Mundengu, and in English, we say you are all welcome. As men of honor, God bless you. Welcome to Jos the Beautiful.
The College of Past Presidents, led by Prince Julius Adelusi, expressed satisfaction over the conference, as the conference had held in Jos 27 years earlier. Pharmacist Muhammad Buddha spoke on their behalf.
When you have been part of nurturing an association that is 95 years old, it always gives you joy and pride. Families in Nigeria are very special, and that's why we, as past presidents, feel always honored to be present at the society's conferences. The Pharmaceutical Society of Nigeria, I always like to remind you, apart from being the oldest, is the best, comprising of trusted, tested, and forthright pharmacists.
Wow.
The College of Past Presidents seated here adorned with their beautiful medallions have been part of laying the building blocks that has brought us to this time.
It was a moment of fiesta and feasts as different technical and interest groups of the PSN had special and ample time for deliberations and planning, while lecture series were also held for the General House. One of such meetings was that of the Clinical Pharmacists Association of Nigeria, CPAN, headed by pharmacist Dr. Joseph Madu, where the launch of International Pharmacy Residency Program in Nigeria was announced. The Nigerian Association of Pharmacists in the Academia, NAPA, led by Dr. Ezekiel Olugbenga Akinkumi, held their meeting too. One of the major topics of discourse in their forum was a retirement hitting many of their members. Several other interest groups held their meetings, including the Association of Lady Pharmacists, led by pharmacist Scholastica Nenna Lan, where a new assistant national secretary was elected, pharmacist Vera Abba. The Young Pharmacists group held theirs too. It was an opportunity for Professor Osifo to admonish them on the need to be more proactive in their life decisions as they are at the stage of risk-taking.
The show is that the young people are actually the driving force of any organization, and PSN is not an exception. And so the success of any conference will actually depend on the young people in that particular conference. One, they are energetic. I'm sure if you came on Saturday, you would have observed young people helping to pack the bag of baggages. They will leave very late, they will come very early. The fellows, they are also active, but a little bit slowly. But one thing I want to challenge us with is this: let no one, like scripture says, look down on you as a youth. You know, one of the things we have in this part of the world is that when you have an idea, somebody tells you it won't work. Or somebody tells you it doesn't matter. Why should we listen to him? Instead, insist on what you believe until you are proven wrong.
The leader of the group, pharmacist Ethel Basimba, Dr. Isiche Pounds, also pledged to help them grow.
It's really a pleasure to be here. To me, the young professionals are the future. You guys are the ones that will make pharmacy practice what it should be. What I'm going to do is talk a little bit about myself. I'll talk about NAPSA, I'll talk about WASPEN, and I'll talk about what I'm doing now. And I will share with you guys ideas that I have in terms of how the young professional group here can work together with the young professional group over there. There has to be collaboration.
There were lots of plenary and lecture series as the lady pharmacists launched their multi-purpose cooperative, led by pharmacist Rose Ageme.
Again, we are welcome to the maiden AGM of Lady Pharmacist Cooperative Multi-Purpose Society. You are all welcome. Our maiden AGM has taken off with an opening prayer. This cooperative is a registered one. The society is a vision by one of us. And by the grace of God, God has helped us and we have come far. This is the certificate of registration of the cooperative. Yes. We are doing this to let you know that it's not a child's play. Like I said, a cooperative is a registered one. Yes, and this is the certificate of registration. This is to show us that the cooperative society is a serious venture that has come to stay. Yes. Yes. Through this cooperative, every member, by the special grace of God, will move from one level of financial status to the very next one. As God will
have. There was a session for Nigeria's presidential candidates. The presidential candidate of the Labour Party LP in Nigeria, Mr. Peter Obi, while pledging partnership with the pharmacists, stated that his administration will ensure that the nation gets to the point of exporting food and pharmaceuticals as production will increase. He spoke through his campaign director in Plateau State, Dr. Nanzing Bako. The standard bearer of the ruling All Progressives Congress, Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, who spoke through the party's governorship aspirant in Plateau State, Dr. Nentawe Yilwatda, noted that pharmacists are precise in finding the root of a problem while narrating a personal experience. The candidate of the New Nigeria People's Party, Dr. Rabiu Musa Kwankwaso, speaking through the gubernatorial candidate of his party in Plateau State, Pastor Dr. Alfred Dafwan, vowed that his administration will ensure that medicine is secured and quality drugs made available for all. The candidate of the African Action Congress, AAC, Omoyele Sowore, observed that the country at present is sick and needs urgent treatment, adding that if pharmacists are not treated right, they will be discouraged to work for the health of the nation. The candidate of the Social Democratic Party, SDP, Prince Adewole Adebayo, noted that the demands of pharmacists were not for themselves, instead for the overall well-being of the country, promising that his government will work with the men of honor. While appreciating the presidential candidates and representatives who turned up for the event, Professor Osifo stressed that the society is apolitical and is willing to work with the eventual winner, while adding that pharmacists and other stakeholders need to know the plans of the aspirants for the health sector to avert possible danger should there be similar occurrence as the pandemic in future. As he handed the pharmacists' Charter of Demands to them, he had earlier presented pharmacists' resolutions to the governor of Plateau State. The men of honor were also treated to cultural night, dinner and banquet night, to justify the saying that all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. With all dance styles and generational music, as a pharmacist turned rapper was unveiled.
Thank you.
The closing banquet was memorable as the governor of Gombe State, Alhaji Inua Yahaya, was in attendance, as the chairman, represented by his senior special advisor on health, Alhaji Dahiru Kara.
So, as I heard from the national president's speech, that Gombe State will be smelling something. It's smelling something next year. So we are ready. For seeing me here, that indicates the political will of His Excellency Governor Muhammad Inua Yahaya, the Executive Governor of Gombe State, for sending me here to be with you, to honor your invitation. And we are ready for the next year.
Several awards were presented too. Gombe will play host to the 2023 edition of the conference. Cultural troupe from the state were at the closing banquet to entertain the guests, just as their Plateau State counterparts had previously done. Several dignitaries were also in attendance. All who were at the TIN CITY 2022 have continued to praise the conference, which they have described as the best national conference so far. Some of the people who spoke to CEO Africa on the conference include past president of the NAPSA, Dr. Anthony Ikeme, the president-elect of the group, pharmacist Emelwe Chukwumeze Ezerim.
I think that the subject matter of this conference is one after my heart. In 2019, at the PSN conference in Kaduna, then as the president of NAPSA, I actually advocated for the proposal that was made by the keynote speaker today, which is for us to create a pharmaceutical science focus group, including NAPSA, PSN, and other stakeholders, including NIPA, to focus on medicine security. No country, no nation can be truly, sufficiently independent in their healthcare without adequate medicine security. And to make that the subject matter of this conference to me is the beginning of a journey that will help us to achieve that dream. So today was awesome, and I'm so excited to be here.
So far, so good. This is the first day for the conference, and I have to tell you, the director of NIPRID that gave the speech was excellent, and the facility where we're at in Nigeria, Chris Band Hotels, this facility has everything that you need. It is excellent. It's an excellent location in Jos. This is my first time ever in Jos. I grew up here in Nigeria. I left Nigeria when I was only 13 years old. I've never been to Jos. But one of the things that PSN has done for me is give me an opportunity to always come back to Nigeria. I come every year, and I'm getting to see different cities in Nigeria. And it is awesome to be here and to be with my people. That's the best part of it. It's always a reunion for me when I come to PSN.
Others whose joy of attending the conference knew no bounds include pharmacist Ike Onyechi, Nkemdilim Ogweji, Tina Aletu, Thomas Omotayo, a director of the Pharmacy Council of Nigeria, Bridget Aladi, Eze Ambrose, the National Vice President and the National Secretary, Association of Community Pharmacists of Nigeria, ACPN.
One word, I'll say splendid. We have had a very good conference with the trendy thing, medicine, security in an unstable economy, and so many soft things that will leave the pharmacists thinking. We have had a conference that has given us a lot of food for thought. We have had our keynote speaker encourage us to go from farm to pharmacy. We have had particularly the community pharmacists being encouraged to think out of the box and make their practice worthwhile. On behalf of myself and my national chairman pharmacist, Wale Oladigbolu, who had to leave for a very important engagement also, I welcome all the community pharmacists who are here at this conference, and I pray for their journey mercy back to their various stations, and I say we love you.
The keynote address was very, very inspiring. And I hope you did it. And the mercy security is something all of us have to put hands on, because it's a national security. And with collaboration and technology, I think, collaboration with other regulatory agencies, and medicine will be accessible and available and affordable to the consumers of health. Well, I wish them well. I thank them for coming, and I know very soon some of them will be going to go back to their real destination. I wish them journey mercies to their destination, and employ them also to continue their areas of practice in the pharma ecosystem, creating part of the society and various departments where areas are working in.
The immediate past chairman of the ACPN, Dr. Samuel Adekola, has not hidden his commendation for the conference as well.
Honestly, I think we must appreciate God and also appreciate the president and his team, and more importantly, the Conference Planning Committee and the people of Jos. Like the keynote speaker, observes. Perhaps maybe not the best conference in the honor of PSN, but in actual sense, with all standards, in recent time, I think the Jos conference has proven to be one of the best conferences. So I think we have every cause to thank God, and I congratulate the president of, for his first conference to have been like this. We should expect better days ahead in his term as president of PSN. So today's opening ceremony has actually shown to us that Jos Conference is a conference of reference.
Many pharmaceutical industries were also around to add to the side attractions through exhibitions and raffle draws.
Hey! Don't sleep! Wake up!
to the vibe. Beat me and I bet.
See, you don't walk, you don't try. You're so close to the vibe.
One of the representatives of the various industries noted that the TIN CITY 2022 was the most organized conference, as their various stands were well arranged.
Wonderful, very beautiful, sincerely speaking. And there's a first in everybody. They are one of the first that did something that I appreciated. On Tuesday, yes, all the speakers were called to the hall to meet, to have a party. That's first of its kind. My sister, we've been to exhibitions that we're looking for people to come and paste this for us. They've not pasted it. Where's my hall? I'm telling you this. After paying you some of money, see the comfort, see the tables, the chairs, everything is more than enough. We went there and they were asking us, okay, any issues that they can be taken care of and all that. I was shocked. I gave a speech there. That me, I'm shocked. For the first time, your fellow exhibitors come and hear from them. They run from us, most conferences. They will just run. They don't want to even know. You will call them, they won't even pick your call. She said, after paying you money, sure, the one before this, I don't want to call their name. The one before this. We didn't have a stand. They are looking for a stand, gave us a stand and all that. We had to face these stickers. It became an issue for Miller Gospel. It was the second of the three that they managed to come and face this work paper for us. I mean, because, but for the first time, the is happening here. So this conference has a whole lot of pluses. The presidential campaign people, presidential aspirants were even around. Okay, the president of PSN was around to address us as exhibitors. We get for the first time, maybe second time, I've been interviewed on my stand. They have cost and then the space. The space. There's a lot of space and security is tight. So I mean, I can't fault them. It can't be perfect. Okay, it can't be perfect, but if I'm to rate this conference, I rate them ahead of any other conference I've attended in PSN, ahead of any other conference. They might not be, 100%, but I'm telling you, this is second to none. As of today, as regards any conferences that I've attended in Nigeria.
They also had first ever dinner with PSN presidents in the history of the PSN conference. All these and more lay more credence to the fact that the future is bright for the society under Professor Usifo. Being his first conference as the president, he has shown the capacity he has and what the society should expect. Professor Usifo promised the subsequent ones would make this present swan a mere crow. The conference ended on November 5 with the handover baton to Gwombe State branch of the PSN, as they will be hosting the Men of Honor in the next edition. Commissioner for Health, Dr. Nimkong La Ndam, represented Governor Lalong at the closing banquet. Oscar Wilde once said, "Anybody can make history. Only a great man can write it." Professor Usifo has not only made history, but he has also written it. His feet are already planted in the sands of time. Congratulations to Professor C.O. Usifo. Congratulations to the Conference Planning Committee. Congratulations to the Pharmaceutical Society of Nigeria.